Hey, this is Carlos Cavallo from datingadviceguru.com. Hey, hang on. I know you're asking, who is this schmuck and where is Matt Coast? Matt is doing his own thing today, and I'm stepping in to give you some great dating advice. Today, I'm going to show you 5 red flag signs that he's losing interest and how to get it back. And before we get cranking along here, I want to encourage you to subscribe to my video channel as well and get double the dose of great dating advice. All right, so you're thinking that he might not be as interested as he once was. And it happens in every relationship, this back and forth dance of attraction. Sometimes they're hot, sometimes they're not. But when a woman senses that a man is disconnecting from her or pulling away, she wants to slam those brakes on and get him back close to her again. Because it's scary. It fills you with kind of a panic and dread when a guy looks like he might be pulling away and losing interest in you. Rule number 1 is don't panic. It's tempting to jump in and start over-nurturing and over-attending to him in the hopes that this is going to slow down or stop his retreat. But in all likelihood, it will just speed up his exit. Hey, it's a major buzzkill to have the guy that you want pinned all your hopes on that is suddenly checked out of the relationship. That sucks, dude. But don't let your emotions run the show. They will just send you into doing things that you know you shouldn't be doing, like calling him too much, texting him too much, lowering your boundaries to get him interested again, maybe acting a little needy. Well, let's jump right in with the signals to look out for that he might be losing interest. The first signal, 1, is he's waffling. Yeah, when a guy stops being gung-ho and excited about seeing you, or really excited about anything about your relationship, you got a problem, Houston. There is a certain level of excuses that tend to come with this territory as well. You might ask him to do something and he starts coming up with some lame reasons why he can't. For example, maybe you guys get together every Saturday for a movie on Netflix, and this time, for the first time in maybe 10 weeks, he says, "Well, I'm just gonna stay home and play video games with the guys." You might be concerned, and it might also be exactly what he said, just a night to hang out with the guys. You see, guys do need to hang out with each other on occasion to restore those connections and get that feeling of manliness going again. And sometimes he will lower the priority of your relationship where he just does his own guy thing. Now, it's not permanent, but he is watching to see how you'll react to him taking a little time for himself. If you're cool, he's cool. And he'll likely be right back at you wanting to hang out again Sunday night after he's itched that little social scratch. But if you start to get needy or act jealous or possessive or, God forbid, even try to stop him from doing this, well, he's going to feel reluctant to pull you back again, and that's not going to keep his interest. It's all in how you respond to him that's going to determine just how fast and how powerful he comes back with his passion. Signal 2 is he's not so excitable. Right up there with his uncertainty is a certain amount of excitement that you want to sense from him. It won't be at the same levels like when you first started dating, but it should still be there. He has to feel a certain level of positive response potential. It's a lot of big fancy words, which really just means he wants to feel good about your relationship. Now, if you sense that he's just not as thrilled with your relationship, there are a few things you can do to stoke the fire. First is shake things up a little, break up the routines, change him around a little bit, scramble his expectations. Make him see another side of you. Maybe you're not the type that swears very much, and well, maybe next time you guys are doing the nasty, give him an earful. You don't like action movies? Take him out to see the latest shoot 'em up. Break his expectations. And give him a reason to look twice at what he's got. Now, look, honey, it's perfectly normal and natural to bask in the glow of other men's interest. And your man needs to see that you're valued by other guys in order to inspire his appreciation for you. It's not cheating. That's just life. And let's stir things up a little. Again, don't wait for him to do it. Women are often viewed by men as being way too passive when it comes to initiating things in the relationship. Take the bull by the horns, and you can take him somewhere new and interesting. You want there to be some fire in that relationship, and that's totally understandable, so do something to get that fire going. Signal 3, he's leaving a yucky aftertaste. See, right after a guy starts losing interest, he starts to act a little negative. If you notice your man starting to behave a little bit nasty and mean on occasion, well, you should stop and take a look at things, especially if you thought you had yourself a real sweetheart. One of the ways he's going to do this is by picking fights with you. He'll get sensitive about stuff or bark over relatively small stuff that he might normally have overlooked. Now, of course, there's a chance he's just stressed out from some other area of his life, but you should be talking and communicating with him enough to know if that's the case. If you walk away from dates and sleepovers with this blah feeling in your stomach, that's a pretty big hint there's something going on. Signal 4, the sex is bipolar. No, what I mean by bipolar is, well, not crazy, well, kind of crazy, but it's that you find that you're either only having sex with him or you're not having any at all. Either situation says something about how he's feeling about you and the relationship. Now, if you're doing the horizontal bop all the time and things feel good in that, well, what are you reading this for? You're fine. But if you're doing the nasty and only the nasty, there's something up. Men typically experience sex in one of two ways: connecting, regular sex, and then the fun and have a little bit of release sex. It's kind of a biological need for most guys. If you're finding that the sex has disappeared, it's a big warning sign, especially if you've acted interested and he just didn't go along for the ride. And finally, signal number five that he's losing interest: he's just not that interested. I mean, it's a pretty obvious sign, the ultimate sign, in fact. Is he asking you questions about your life? Does he seem like he still cares about your welfare? Does he show concern for the things going on in your life? And is he still asking you questions? Because if he's not interested in what's going on with you and your conversation is hollow and boring, you probably got a problem right there. It's only natural that he will become more comfortable around you over time in a relationship, and he might not jump into immediately asking you questions, but he should show at least some genuine interest on a regular basis. Is he asking you questions about stuff you've talked about or mentioned? Is he paying attention to the things you tell him are important to you? Again, it's not too much to ask. It's simple enough and you should expect it. Yes, this is something you're entitled to in a relationship. Now, before we finish up, I've got two other rules for you. Rule number two is, if he's not meeting your relationship needs, you must demand them. Not in an unhealthy way, mind you, but it's up to you to ensure that those needs are getting met. I see a lot of women sacrifice their own needs to stay in a relationship, and ultimately, it never works. You need to get those met. And that final rule, number three, is if he's starting to withdraw or pull away from you, you've got to get your power back. Your power is the power of keeping him engaged and obsessed with you. A man has to be kept in this healthy cycle of desire and obsession for you. That's your power as a woman. Do you know how to regain that power if you've lost it? Well, that's just one of the many things I teach women on my YouTube channel. So either go to the link you see on the video or click the link you see below the video or somewhere around here. I'm sure there's going to be something popping up that you can click. Go on over to my channel and subscribe by all means and get twice the dose of great dating advice. And again, Matt will be back with your next video. This is Carlos Cavallo from DatingAdviceGuru.com. Make sure you do that big three, like this video. Make sure you subscribe both to mine and his. And always leave your comments and questions below. I'll be talking again soon. This is Carlos Cavallo. As always, live and love with passion. Hey, this is Carlos Cavallo from DatingAdviceGuru.com. Thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, click the link you see on the right side of the video to go to my channel and subscribe. I've got a ton of great relationship and dating advice for you to get right now.